Razavani for FightHype.com with me. I'm head of Sky Sports Boxing, Mr. Adam Smith. Adam, you alright?
Very good. Very good mood today.
I'm sure I'm in a very good mood. I slept last night. And this press conference was very early this morning. Normally it's around midday, 1 o'clock start. So.
Yeah.
But I had the energy for some reason. Can you elaborate why I may have that?
Yeah, very happy Liverpool winning the battle of the two legs, I guess. It was a little bit nervy in the last 10-15 minutes in Rome last night. I wish I was in Rome. I'm a big Liverpool fan. Have been since I was very young. My kids are huge Liverpool fans. My boy I brainwashed. My girl has just got a passion. She just is in love with most of them. Mo Salah at the top of her list at the moment. Absolutely. I love my football club, and I was obviously on cloud nine, as the whole Smith household were. And by hook or by crook, I will work out a way to get to Kiev. I mean, I think the Klitschkos owe me a little favour. I mean, Vitaly's the mayor, and Vladimir owns a hotel there, and obviously they both live there. I mean, we've worked together for a long time. Surely I don't have to sleep on the streets and, you know, beg for some sort of room for the night. So I hear there's no accommodation, very few flights, and very few tickets. At the moment, I'm sort of without most things. So, like you, I'm going to try and hunt my way through and find a way to get to Kiev.
Give me a dance partner. raise your hand and I'll fly with you. Adam, I just want to talk about the most latest scenario. We'll come to Haye Bellew shortly, obviously. Stephen Espinosa came out a number of weeks ago. The president of the WBC, Mauricio Sulaiman, came out a number of weeks ago. They both said that we will happily assist and mediate between Anthony Joshua's camp and Deontay Wilder's camp. It was just missing yourself to come out and say, we'll help mediate as well.
I think we're all mediators in this. You know, Stephen and I met for a drink the other night in New York, and, you know, we're in the same sort of boat. You know, we both have our TV commitments. He's Showtime, I'm Sky, of course, and there's Peter Nelson of HBO, who I'm sure will be interested in a big fight like this. But Showtime are the ones that have covered Anthony and Deontay for a long time now. And Stephen was saying, look, if it helps, and Eddie and Shelley can't get in the room together, then, you know, I'll go, and maybe you should come with us, and Al Heyman can come, or whatever. Look, I think there's a lot of people that are trying to make this fight, who want this fight to happen. Ultimately, it's going to come down to the two fighters agreeing the deal. I've spoken to both Anthony and Deontay in the last week. Both of them want this fight hugely. And I believe that if the two fighters want the fight, it will happen. It's just a question of when. I think the $50 million was a clever card. It was a huge number to put in front of Team Joshua. But obviously, you don't want to go into a situation where you don't have any say. There's no contract. There's no rematch clause. It has to be in America. What broadcast commitments are they going to have? You know, we obviously have to have it on Sky. We want it on Sky, so we have to push that very much. And, you know, the feeling from the Joshua camp is they very much want the fight in the UK. I think, look, there can be compromises in all of these things. I think Josh will go out to the States. I think the fight could happen in Vegas. You know, it's huge money wherever it happens, but I think that the control is a big thing, and I think that Eddie will go back now to Shelley and Al, and hopefully that, you know, everybody can sort of give and take a little bit, and they've got a big money. There's enough money in it for both. There's enough money for Anthony, there's enough money for Deontay. So it's got to work. It's just a few other little bits and pieces that have got to be put together. I'm confident that the fight will happen. I just don't know whether it will happen next. You've got the Alexander Povetkin situation with the WBA. You know, Dominic Brazil's waiting for a shot at Wilder. I know they've penciled something in if Wilder and Joshua doesn't happen, probably for August. You know, rightfully so. And Joshua's probably penciled something in maybe for around that time, or September in the UK. Because, you know, these journeys have to go on if the big fight can't be made. But I think there's real willingness from both fighters to get this over the line. I just don't know when.
Adam, you mentioned that obviously Peter Nelson may be interested in HBO.
Of course.
But wouldn't it be, obviously, with Joshua being on Showtime, I think five fights now is on Showtime?
Yeah, I mean, Stephen Espinosa, to be fair, they put their money in their pocket. And, you know, yes, they had the HBO, had the Klitschko fight, because obviously they had Vladimir. But, you know, they the contractual situation with Matchroom and Anthony is, you know, is hopefully going to get sorted. I mean, that's that's widely known that that's up for renewal, and you know that needs to be taken care of. And obviously, same again, you know, they need to work out who Anthony's going to fight with on American television. And I think Showtime are in prime position because they've showed loyalty to him, and you know they've put him out a number of times now. HBO is a huge platform as well. I saw Peter and obviously around the Katie Taylor night the other night. I was very disappointed they didn't take the Katie Taylor fight live. I was pretty strong in my feelings about that. But you know, Peter's a great guy, and they've got a great setup at HBO. They've obviously got a huge platform we've worked with before. We're very tied to them in many ways with Sky Atlantic, and I don't know. They're both great, and I think that you know, AJ's got a big decision to make. First decision is, you know, does he want to take the Wilder fight next? I think he wants it, so let's see how that happens. But you know, let's. I think it'll end up on Showtime and Sky, but we've got to wait and see.
There's a lot of rumours circulating back in the blast that Anthony Joshua was going to look to move to HBO as his American broadcaster. If that was to happen, it hasn't happened yet, but if that was to happen, does that make the Deontay Wilder fight even more difficult to happen?
You'd have thought so, because, you know, Stephen Espinosa and Al Heyman are close, Showtime are close to Al Heyman's fighters. Nothing's impossible in this game, you know. It took how many years to make Mayweather Pacquiao? You know, we never thought that would happen. You know, these things can be made. I think it's also important that, you know, fights, Mayweather Pacquiao happened too late. We could have had three by the time it happened. You know, Junior Widow, Ricky Hatton never fought. You know, Amir Khan and Colbrook, we always talk about it. When's it going to happen? You've got to get these fights over the line. It's important. And there's a lot of money in this one. Huge money in it. So I think it can be worked out. Just needs, you know, egos to be put to one side. The fighters have got to have the right deal. And I think this is very possible, this fight to make, because of the willingness of both Anthony and Deontay. But I'm sure that, obviously, you know, Showtime are desperate for the fight, Sky are desperate for the fight, because we've, you know, shown a lot of faith in both fighters and longevity. Obviously, we've got a huge relationship with Anthony Joshua as an ambassador for us. So it's very important we get the fight. But HBO will look to, you know, pitch their self to Anthony Joshua over the course of the next weeks and months, just like Showtime will, because you know they're a great outfit too. But it's Anthony's decision, no to do with me. For me, it's I'm looking, you know, all I want is the best for Sky, and I believe that we provide the best for Anthony, for Sky box office. I think it's the best platform, and I think Anthony's very happy with that.
If you're a betting man, are we more likely to see Kell Brook and McConnor, Deontay Wilder, or Anthony Joshua this year?
That's a really good question. I'd like to see both this year. I'd like to see, in a dream world, I'd like to see Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder fight in November, and Amir Khan and Kell Brook fight in December. That'll be perfect for me. Obviously, that puts a question mark over the UK. It would have to be in Cardiff, you'd have thought, with a roof in that time of year. So maybe you'd think of Vegas for it. I'd like to see Deontay Wilder, possibly, and Anthony Joshua fight in Vegas first, and then with a rematch. And a rematch has to happen. There has to be a clause for a rematch at Wembley, maybe in April.
Even if one of the fighters won convincingly?
I think so. I think they're both putting a lot on the line here. And I think Anthony doesn't need Deontay as much as Deontay needs Anthony. Whatever they say, you know, Anthony's got four belts. He can sell out 80,000 crowds, probably fighting you or me. It doesn't really matter. People are going to find a way to get to Anthony Joshua. He's huge here. Deontay Wilder is not huge in America. He's a great personality. He's a wonderful fighter. He's got everything. He's got the power. He's got the WBC belt, which many eyes is the most prestigious, so he brings a lot to the table. He's unbeaten, and you need dance partners. Morales, Pereira, Bo Holyfield, Gatti Ward, obviously back in the day, Ali Frazier, you know, the four, Hearns, Leonard, Duran, and Marvin Hagler, of course, the four of them. And it's, you know, it's important that there are dance partners for trilogies, for rematches, all that sort of stuff. And I think Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder can fight three times. So yeah, if I was involved, I'm involved, you know, as you say, a mediator of sorts, but I'm not involved in the negotiations. That's between Eddie Hearn and Al Heyman and Shelley Finkel. That's up to them to get this fight made. But if I was in that room, I would be saying there has to be a rematch clause for both fighters. You know, certainly for Anthony Joshua, because, you know, if you're going over there to America, you've got to have, you know, it's too big a name, too big a star. There's too much on the line. I think that's, as Eddie said up there, you know, a smart promoter gets rematch clauses in. Has to happen. So I think that's a real big point for this fight to take place. Your question was, what's more likely to happen? Kell Brook is desperate for the Amir Khan fight. I hope Amir Khan is as desperate for the Kell Brook fight. I think they both want it. There's a lot of money involved. Again, it's a fight that has to happen. I think the weight is an issue. I think Amir wants it at 147. Kell will want it anywhere between 150 and 154. I would personally say, listen, let's make it at 150. Let's get a two-fight deal going on. Whatever happens in the first, you have a second. And that's, again, the way to make sort of big fights. You know, Anthony Joshua and Vladimir Klitschko were going to have a rematch. Vladimir was the one that decided, you know what, probably best to call time on a gallant defeat, and what a gallant defeat it was. I think with Anthony Joshua doing too, Oliver a lot younger, you know, there needs to be some cushion here, and I think people expect that. You know, that's why the 50 million was amazing at the beginning when you actually look at it. You know, if you saw a house for 50 million, a big mansion with all the land in the world, you know, and you walk in and there's a couple of holes in there, you know, you've signed the agreement, you've got to have a contract. There's got to be a way of doing this. And I think Shelley Finkel and Al Haymon have the money. I don't think there's any doubt about that. And Showtime, they have the money. I think that 50 million can be found and guaranteed. Don't worry about that. But there has to be talk about the broadcasters. There has to be talk about the sites. There has to be talk about rematches. You know, that's still out there.
Must have been Deontay put his Instagram post out. He said in that, just, do you accept the money? I know Eddie got hounded in America by the American media, and they're all saying to Eddie, well, why don't you say, yes, we're happy and we'll accept 50 million. Now let's sit in a room and discuss the rest of the
game. Yeah, no, and Shelley, like, I spent time with Shelley Finkel, that's exactly what he said. You know, agree the money and then come in the room. Well, you know, and he's saying, oh, they didn't, you know, we didn't get a contract for the $12.5 million and blah, blah, blah. They said they didn't accept it. He says, she says, whatever. They've got to get into a room. Now, this fight's not going to be made unless they're in a room. Maybe Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder have got to get into a room. I don't know. But if they don't want to, it has to be Al Haymon and Eddie Hearn in a room together. Yeah, that's the only way this fight can be made, okay? If they want mediators, if they want the likes of Stephen or me or anyone else or Barney Francis, you know, in a room, then that's fine. You know, if that's what it takes to try and make the fight happen. But really, it's up to Eddie and Al Haymon to make this fight. And I think there's a lot of willingness from Deontay's side and from Anthony's side to get it over the line. But ultimately, that's not my job. That's their job to get over the line. And we all want it as fight fans as well. Joshua Wilder will happen, but I think Khan and Brook might happen first.
Well, let's hope so, obviously.
We'll see. We just hope they don't both not happen, because that would be just such a shame, wouldn't it? What we do know that's going to happen is this fight.
No, it is. Yeah.
David Haye and Tony Bellew.